In the last video I did, I introduced my new to me Mac Pro. I showed some benchmarks and I received a lot of questions about how I flashed my MSI R9 280X with a EFI enabled BIOS. So instead of answering all the questions individually, I decided to make a video about it. By default, Mac 4 ones were delivered with the NVIDIA GeForce GT120. But my Mac had the optional ATI Radeon HD 4870 installed. My advice would be to keep your original GPU, you never know when you might need it. What's also advised is to do the actual flashing of your new GPU using DOS, but I couldn't get a bootable USB thumb drive working on my Mac Pro. My solution was to use ATI WinFlash using Windows 10. I have a spare Samsung SSD lying around with Windows 10 installed. So let's start by opening the case. In my case, I had already installed the new R9 280X GPU. Let's disconnect all the Mac drives. And install the Windows 10 SSD drive. Now, all the R9 280X GPUs I know have a dual BIOS feature. This allows you to choose from two different BIOSes stored on the GPU. Use the switch on the card to select the first or second BIOS, or as I like to call them, BIOS A and B. Before starting any flashing, make sure your Mac boots with the switch set to both the A or B mode. And when doing the actual flashing, make sure to only flash one of the options, A or B. That way, if anything goes wrong, you can always set the switch back to the other mode and use it as your backup BIOS. Now that Windows 10 has booted, log in, and we will download the EFI BIOS from the Mac Rumors forum. It's in the third post by Mr. Zaniwoop. Now I have the exact same card as he has, and I'm not sure if this particular EFI BIOS will work on other cards. So be advised, and I am not responsible for any damage to your expensive video cards. Let's open the zip file and extract the BIOS ROM file into a new folder. I already downloaded ATI WinFlash into the same folder. We'll open up ATI WinFlash, and please, please, please do backup your current BIOS. To do so, just hit the save button, and we will first save the A BIOS. Then flip the switch on the card and do the same procedure again and name it Backup B. Just to be absolutely safe and sure, you can also copy these to a USB flash drive. Now let's flash the downloaded EFI enabled BIOS to the card. This will take a while, and to illustrate this, I haven't sped up this part of the video. Just be patient and let the flasher do its work. Also, do not power off your machine while flashing. The best thing is to just not touch it until it's done. When it is done, shut down your machine, remove the Windows SSD, slide your Mac disks back in, and power on your Mac Pro. If everything went okay, you should see the Apple logo on boot. This means your R9 280X is EFI enabled. On my MSI card, all ports work, both the mini display port, the DVI and the HDMI port. Good luck with flashing your own card, and if you like this video, like, comment or subscribe.